The biggest prank I've ever pulled is an April Fool's joke. I was in high school, and I had a very good friend of mine in high school who wasn't as good at school as I was. And we were in a math class together, and I was a good friend, and I would allow him on occasion to peek over and get an answer in math. Well, our teacher, and I remember his name was Mr. Abramowitz, caught us a couple of times, and he always made it very clear that he wasn't happy with it. It turned out on April Fool's Day, my friend was absent, and I saw an opportunity to play a nice April Fool's joke on a good friend of mine. So I went home that day, and we talked on the phone, and I hatched my plan, and I said, Mr. Abramowitz had caught us cheating again, and I'm sorry to say, but we both got suspended. I started to giggle and suppress my laugh, and he thought I was crying, and he said, David, are you crying? And I said, yeah. And he hung up the phone and drove right over. You could hear the screeching of the tires down the street. He lived about two blocks. And then when he came back to my house, I informed him it was an April Fool's joke, and I think the reaction was what you'd expect from an 18-year-old guy. He chased me around the house and said some choice words to me, and lo and behold, we weren't suspended. But I thought that was a pretty good joke, and I've carried that through. I do a lot of April Fool's jokes with my friends and family, so I'm kind of known for that. So I do have a little bit of a devious streak, so be careful on April Fool's Day.